federal lawmakers in the House of Representatives have described the unveiling of the ministerial list as a welcome development. They also charged the nominees to hit the ground running when they are finally screened, so as to work in line with the mantra of change which the present administration had promised Nigerians.
If you look at the list holistically, you will discover that these are people, they are not first timers in governance. These are people that have ruled several states, certain states. I believe we have about six governors or more governors, like former governors. They understand the expectations of the people. They were also administrators in the past. They know the mantra of change that the APC has brought into the Nigerian political system today. So definitely we don't expect anything beyond that mantra.
President Muhammadu Buhari on Tuesday sent to the House of Representatives a request for the approval of the 2016-2018 medium-term expenditure framework and fiscal strategy paper. The 2016-2018 framework was presented by the leader of the House, Honorable Femi Gbajabiamila. The framework is the general principles that will guide the 2016 budget.
The leader of the House presented the framework as prepared by the federal government, by the president. It was laid before the House for discussion. This actually is the general principles that will guide the 2016 budget. As you know, Appropriation Act is like any other law, which to us must be obeyed. The compliance is almost total because it's an act of the National Assembly if signed into law. So the federal government, in a bid to ensure compliance, will send us the guidelines to ensure that what is presented in the guidelines will be the framework.
While presenting the medium-term expenditure framework, the House leader, Honorable Femi Gbajabiamila, called for the need to speedily pass the 2016-2018 framework as it also focuses on diversification of the economy.
That we very speedily pass this MTEF, because before we even get into the 2016 budget, this MTEF has to be passed. We're now in December, we're closing out pretty fast, and I think there's a need for speed, even without sacrificing the thoroughness that needs to go into it. This MTF needs to be passed speedily.
Speaking with OGTV News, Honorable Kayode Oladele, representing Imeko Afon Egbalu North, commended the framework as federal government benchmarked $38 per barrel of oil price.
The federal government benchmarked this year's, the 2016 budget, at $38 per barrel. To me, it is more realistic because we are like looking at almost rock bottom price. Of course, we are not exchanging our crude for nothing. So if we are now looking at $38 per barrel, instead of shooting at it and benchmarking it at, let's say, $80 and having an overbloated budget that will not be realizable at the end of the day, I think that will be something that will not be advisable.
Meanwhile, the Speaker of the House, Honorable Yakubu Dogara, has directed committees on finance, national planning and economic development, and legislative budget and research to scrutinize and come up with recommendations to the House.
Committee, for the purpose of this exercise, is a subcommittee of the Appropriation Committee. So what that means is that we are going to take a look at what they have requested from us, what they want us to do, and then make a very big, very strong case to support their demand for more funds. So I won't say I'm entirely pleased, I'm not actually pleased, but we'll try our best possible to make sure that we get them sufficient funding.
With several international bodies for the investigative activities, which frequently make it a must for staff of the Commission to travel to other countries. In line with the foregoing, this committee may wish to consider and approve the inclusion of the sum of $160 million as requested in the Commission budget proposal submitted to the Ministry we urge the National Assembly to maintain the provisions of 220,600,000 naira for the purchase of additional vehicles as proposed by the Ministry. Accordingly, it is my honor and privilege to present to this honorable committee EFC budget proposal for the 2006 financial year in the sum of 11,422,991,540 naira as capital.